Haykum. I'm Brother Abdul Azim Muhammad. I'm a second degree black belt in VSK Wu Jiu-Jitsu under my teacher, Grandmaster Anthony Muhammad. Glad to be able to sit down today and talk about my little experience, with the dot. I'm kind of like a little grandchild. It's how I think about myself with relationship to the doctor. I started training with the Grandmaster in 1995. I became a member of the Nation of Islam, and at the same point in time, he was coming to Chicago. He was appointed by Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan as National Trainer of the Nation of Islam. I'd had some experience, limited experience in martial arts. I'd gotten to maybe an orange belt level in Taekwondo and trained with a couple of different masters in Taekwondo. So a limited basis, but it wasn't really until 95 that I really found what I was looking for, man. Seeing the Grandmaster and seeing jiu-jitsu, it was just amazing. And our style of jiu-jitsu is something that I'd never seen done anywhere. I never even thought about it, to see black men, and mud cloth and kente cloth, hakamas, man, doing the type of thing that they were doing. So long and short of it, man, we all pretty much had to train as members of FOI with Grandmaster in Chicago at that point in time. And it was that year that he brought his teacher to Chicago. I believe that it was at Harlan High School or Tuohy Park in 1995 that we did the first annual seminar, and Doc was there. And I can remember at that point in time, Doc's, he was still mobile. You could still see he was very dangerous, but he was kind of sitting down. He was walking on a cane at that point in time. And I can remember when he was just sitting down thinking, oh wow, this is Dr. Powell, not in an arrogant way or anything like that, but just thinking like I was expecting man to be 8 feet tall and just growling and stuff like that. But he was, even though he was still menacing, he wasn't what I had seen in the tapes when he was young. He was more mellowed out. But when he started to do his thing, it was just incredible, incredible. I can remember that first seminar, I had gotten into pretty good shape. I was lifting weights, running, that type of thing. And during that first seminar, I can remember the doc seated in front of us, and he had us all get into a crab walk position. And as he was giving the commands to go left, right, back, forth, left, right, I can remember the cramps in my stomach, man. It just, just being just extremely fatigued and sweat falling off onto the gym floor. And when he saw that he had killed us after about maybe 20 minutes of crab walking, he said, "Brothers, there's a little book called How to Eat to Live. You need to go and pick it up." So, he was like his student or the Grandmaster. He was, he had fun. Let's put it, he was a master comedian too. Doc to me, I've was like a grandfather. And I say, like, if you had the type, some of the grandparents that I had, you knew that when you saw your grandparents, you didn't, go around them and be disrespectful or you didn't get out of pocket because you was gonna get a beating, put it like that. So it kind of, when I was around him, he was scary to me, until maybe like later on in my training, yeah, I felt a little bit warmer to him, and we had interactions, after I made showdown level, etc. The last time that I really had a conversation with him outside of his last birthday was myself, Professor Joaquin, and Sensei Sharif were in a hotel room in Miami, Florida, during one of Grandmaster Shanique's seminar times. And he really kind of sat down and talked about his life as an FOI to me, talked about, what I asked him, what caused him to come up with the name Sanukis. He told me a story about how when he was living in a project someplace near LaGuardia, I think is what he said, he was sitting in his room meditating, and he said that the lights from the command tower were pulsating through the room. And as he meditated that light, and his breathing and everything came into accord, and he just started to hear that name reverberate through his mind. Sanukis, 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 you know. So, that was what he told me, about that. You know, he talked about, like I said, his life as an FOI, lieutenant in the FOI. He talked about some of his early training experiences and his abilities and his relationship with his teacher, Grand Professor V, and just gave good advice for us as young martial artists, of direction to take. And more so than anything, it just was, a beautiful experience to, get a chance to sit with, like I say, my grandfather, one time, and just, feel that type of love from him. I talked to him on his birthday before he made his transition. He just gotten back, from my understanding, from a dinner with Grandmaster Shanique and his wife and some of the other, people from Atemi Ru. And he seemed tired, but he was in good spirits. And, it was just, of course, a devastating thing for us, even as second generation, for us to lose such a great teacher, but, I try to keep the katas alive, I'm trying to learn more of the Pia and Sanukis, etc. And when we train, he's always, alive in our hearts, man, and, in our spirits, So, that's it.